CQDX. This is Havana calling. CQDX. This is Radio Havana calling all shortwave listeners and radio amateurs. Welcome to DXers Unlimited, Radio Havana's weekly feature dedicated to the fascinating world of radio communication.
Hola, amigos radio aficionados, all around the world. Hi, my friends. Yes, it is time right now for you to enjoy about 10 minutes of all Radio Havana's latest information coming to you from sunny, beautiful La Habana, Cuba. Wonderful weather here. I'm your host, Arnaldo Arnie Porto, Radio Amateur CO2JK, and here's item one of today's show. High frequency, 8-year band propagation will show a slight improvement. That's my forecast. A sudden upsurge in the daily sun potential is something that may happen at any time even at the bottom of the cycle. Now, as we move into the end of spring and the beginning of summer, we have a big event from 3 watts power level, no higher than that. Now please stay tuned for more radio related information coming to you from sunny La Habana, Cuba. Temperature is about 25 degrees during the daytime. Delicious spring weather. We're enjoying really nice spring weather, amigos, and many tourists coming in also to visit us at this time of the year. I'll be back in a few seconds after station ID. Wait. Sure, this is Radio Havana Cuba, and I'm Arnie Porto coming to you via shortwave and also from the streaming audio at www.radiohc.cu. I'm CO2KK, my ham radio full time, and here's now item 3 of today's middle of the week edition of DXers Unlimited. It's now Ask Arnie, Pregúntale a Arnaldo. The Ask Arnie is the number one remote caller section of this show, according to today's question sent by listeners from the United States, Japan, India, Mexico, and Chile. Among the most recently received messages with questions, and they all want to know more about the most popular antennas that can be used to improve reception at locations with very high noise levels. Very important at this time, a very high noise level due to the operation of heated mode power supplies and other devices that can boost the radio frequency spectrum tremendously. Now, this is a really challenging question, amigos, but I will try to provide you with information of two of my favorite low-cost TX capable antennas for the 20, 17, 15, 12, and 10 meter amateur band. They are not multi-band antennas, it must be made for the specific ones. They are not multi-band antennas. It must be made for the specific band you want to operate. Single-band antennas. The top difficulties for them are really good. You are able to install the antenna in the clear. The product number one is made using locally available and low-cost materials. Antenna type 1, as I call it, is known as the one-third of the wavelength vertical. One-third of the wavelength vertical, 120 electrical degrees vertical, using 4-quarter wave elevated radio, dropping at a 45-degree angle. It produces a low takeoff angle, vertical radiation pattern, and it is perfect match for fixed structure cable feed lines. Very easy to match. I used the 20 meter band version for many years, and my team of watch many times did a little better as a single delivery by several more active local amateur stations. It's better than that. Also, the better than that amateur.